And I was headed to Glenn football practice. Then I had to go get Darius from basketball practice. And I had been gone since 6 o'clock that morning. That's the norm for me. Leave 6 in the morning, get home after 9 o'clock. That's my normal schedule. I'm used to that. So when I was telling Miss Betty, when I was talking, I was like, oh, I'm not home yet. I'm getting my son from basketball, football practice. Then I had to go get my baby from football practice. She was like, May, I don't know how you do it, May. Can't nobody help you, May? Poor baby, she was like, you don't have nobody. She was depressing me. I don't care with doing what I do because it's my norm. That's what I do. I do what I think, and that's just my normal routine and my normal schedule. But when she was talking, I was like, Jack. I started to feel bad. I was like, dang, that is. I said, Miss Bell, I'm going to call you back. Hey, if that's my norm and I done got used to my norm, I don't need to think about my norm and start getting depressed about my norm. So I was like, Lord, it's gonna be okay. It's going to be okay. So I was just thinking, you know, a lot of times when we speak, and testify and, you know, tell the goodness of God. And sometimes we're afraid to speak certain things because we feel like the enemy gonna take it and run with it and use it against us and try to try us in that area and make us out to be a lie. I make our testimony out to be a lie. So when I was thinking about that, you know, and I was like, but the enemy can't shut my mouth. I can't allow the enemy to shut my mouth and shut down my praise because my praise is my breakthrough, my praise is my strength, my praise is my next level. And then I thought about it. The scripture came to me, Revelation 12 and the 12th chapter, 11th verse. And it says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. So we overcome by the words of our testimony. We overcome by telling the good news of God. We overcome by sharing our, you know, trials and tribulation and letting someone else know that, you know, you're not in this alone. We in this fight together. We going to make it together. So I just tell God, thank you for all that I go through. I tell God, thank you for my trials and my tribulation. I tell God, thank you, even when the enemy come up against me, because the enemy can't do nothing with a child of God. He can try to impede our progress, but he can't do nothing with us because we are children of the Most High. And being children of the Most High, our job is to keep our eye to the hill from which comes our help. Realize all our help comes from the Lord. And don't look at our problem and don't look at our situation. Just say this too shall pass. Our situation, we got to put a word on our situation. But sometimes our situation just overwhelm us to the point where we just have to sit still and just breathe and recollect ourselves. Because it's so much sometimes, and it's just so much to have to deal with and so much to have to endure. But once you take that moment, you have to shake that off. And you got to give God a praise. You got to just tell God, I know that this too shall pass. God, I tell you, thank you for everything. During my week, and when everything was coming up against me, I was doing that. And the more I did that, the more something came up. I was doing that. The more I did that, the more something came up. I was so overwhelmed. I went to training that Thursday. And when I went to training, the people who were conducting the training were so lost. I said, Lord, I'm so tired. I could have just went home and got in my bed. Why am I here? It had to turn into an argument. It had to dispute. We in training now. I said, Lord, I just can't. I can't. When training was over, it was late, but I went to the Riverwalk. And I just walked. And I just walked. And I just walked. And I just prayed. And I just talked to the Lord. And I just, as I finished, I sat there on the water because I got to walk this word. If I believe in God and I trust God, I got to trust the word. God. And the word said, cast your cares upon him. So I went to the water to cast my cares upon the Lord because I needed some strength to face tomorrow, and I needed some strength to keep going because I was weak. I'm only human and flesh, and I was overwhelmed, and I was burdened down. So I needed some strength just to go a little further. So I sat down, and I just saw the water just flowing so peaceful. I said, just as the river river flow. God, I pray that you ask my spirit man to flow in peace. God, I ask that you help me to soar above all my trials and tribulations. Because in the book, when it says that he will renew your strength and you will mount up as wings of an eagle. And when you study the eagle fly above the storm. The eagle is the only bird that can fly over the storm. And the storm is going on, the eagle is above the storm. And as he's above the storm, he's safe. So he that dwells in the place and the secret of the Most High may abide under the shadow of the Almighty. So I just got to continue to walk this word. I got to continue to believe this word. And I got to continue to trust God, because in 1 Timothy, 2 Timothy, the first chapter, at the 6th verse, it said, wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in thee, by the putting on of my hand. So God got to put on his hand upon us to stir up the gift, because the gift is already there. For God has not given us a spirit of fear. See, the enemy tried to give us a spirit of fear when he don't want us to open our mouth and tell the good news of God. I share what the Lord had done for us, because we're afraid that the enemy's going to type us in what we said, in what we believe. Because we believe it, he's going to try to type us and snatch our belief. But he did not give us a spirit of fear, but a power. You got to know you powerful. And when you're powerful, and you know that life lies in the power of your tongue, if you power, you got to speak power. You got to speak life. You got to walk tall. You got to walk like you got power. You got to talk and act like you in control. And you got power over your situation. Even when everything falls apart, I got this under control. Because he that sit high and look low, he going to take care of it. So I got this. I got power. I shall sustain. I shall be sustained. And I shall be held up as I go through. And of love and of a sound mind. And when you say of a sound mind, that enemy will talk to you like a natural born man. And when he be talking to you, he be talking to you about your situation. And what he be saying be true. What if he saying so true, because it's your situation and what you're going through, but you can't look at that. You got to look beyond that. Because your situation is really not what God has in store for you. It's just something that you got to go through to get to the next level. And God's trying to see if you're ready. If you're prepared to go to the next level, and in order to be prepared to go to the next level, you got to endure what you're going through right now, because God can't use no power soldier. You can't be no coward soldier and be on the Lord's side, because you ain't ready for the next level. So when I got off the phone with my mama, and I'm sitting in the car, and I just felt myself breaking down, I had to look upon him for strength. I couldn't break down at that moment, because I had to go a little further. So when you're going through your trial, your tribulation, and you just don't know which way to turn, and sometimes it just seems like everything you try is just not... it's not coming together. The Bible says all things work together for the good of those who are called according to his purpose. So you got to believe God's word. You got to walk on his word. You got to trust his word no matter what goes on. Because the Bible says heaven and earth shall pass away, but the word of God shall not. It shall not. And since it shall not, you shall not. And you got to be bold enough and strong enough to know that you shall not. You shall not be moved. You shall be like a tree planted by the river of water. I shall not. I shall not be moved. Well, I have to tell the enemy, no matter what you throw up against me, I shall not go under. I shall not be defeated. I shall not be moved. I am a child of the Most High. No matter what I go through, no matter what I endure, I shall overcome. Because the Bible says I'm an overcomer. And I got to believe and know that I'm an overcomer. No matter what overcomer. And I just tell God, thank you. But sometimes in this life, I just get so overwhelmed. I just get so burdened. But I just still tell God, thank you. I got to find my secret place and look to the hills and tell my God, thank you. Yes. And I know that this too shall pass. I know that greater things are in store for me. But in order to get to the great, I got to endure my trial. I got to keep looking up. I got to treat my fellow man right. I got to do what the word of God say to you. I got to live according to his word. The Bible says, lay down every weight and sin that so the joy that was set before him in that same scripture. He endured the cross.
Yes.
He knew it was joy on the other side of that cross.
Yes,
but
yes.
He had to endure being whipped.
Yes.
He had to endure drinking that bitter vinegar.
Yes.
He had to endure being killed and buried.
What?
Because he knew he was going to have joy. And in 3 days, he was going to rise again.
Yes.
Oh, for the joy that is set before me.
Yeah.
I shall endure my trials and tribulations. Because I know that it's joy on the other side in this life.
Yes.
So you got to say, for the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Yes.
And I shall overcome all my trials and my tribulations.
Yes.
And when the enemy comes up against you, you got to go deep down in your spirit and pull up a brick.
Yes.
Because the enemy can't do nothing with you. You can pray to God.
Yes.
But he don't understand your prayer.
Yes.
All this hell you're going through,
yes,
you got audacity to still pray to God.
Yes.
Yes, I do.
Yes.
Because I know God is the one who's going to come and see about me and deliver me.
Yes.
He'll come when we want it.
Yes.
But he always on time.
Always.
Amen. He don't bring us out how we feel like we should come out.
Uh-huh.
Like I was telling my mama the other day, I'm tired of fighting.
Yes.
I just feel like I done got to a point where God should be carrying me and I shouldn't have to fight. I should have a season in my life where I can rest and not fight. And the Bible says there is a season where you shall rest and you don't have to fight.
Uh-huh.
But unfortunately, if I ain't resting right now, that ain't my season to rest.
Yeah.
It ain't my season to rest.
Yeah.
I got to keep on fighting.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I got to also know that Jesus is mindset, the Lord, that he shall repay.
Yeah.
So I got to know how to fight.
Yes.
And let me tell you how I fight. I fight on my knees.
Yes.
And I pray and give it to God.
Yes.
I fight when I praise him and tell him all about my problems.
Yes.
I fight when I don't let the enemy call me to get down in the corner and give up and cry.
Yes.
I fight when I stand still one time and wait on the
Lord.
And all that he shall be about me.
Don't be talking about, I wonder why this is happening. Because the enemy knows
your heart. He know how you love the Lord. He know how the Lord is blessing you. He know how the Lord is bringing anointings upon your life. He already know. So he gonna put your bills before you, glory to God, so you can give it up.
That's right. It's his job.
But that's what he don't know. There ain't no giving up.
Amen.
Just like she said, we got to be like the eagle. We got to fly above our storm. We got to walk over, hallelujah, the mess that you done put down for me, so I can let you know I am an overcomer. When you see me, I'm not alone. I'm with a band of angels, glory to God. And they're watching over me. People wonder how you got over. But I prayed and I got over. I talked to the Lord and I got over. Thank you, Jesus. I had faith to know that God could do it and he would do it, and I got over. See, when you lose, glory to God, track on God, the enemy is able to just walk right in and just take over. Amen. But the fearful things of this world, it only comes to make us turn from God. But when you got the love of God way deep down on the inside, amen. Just like the sister testified of the cancer that was in her body, amen, and how only God, see, this is what you got to know. Yes. Only God can do.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What
amen.
No other power can do.
Yes.
Only God can.
Yes.
And you got to know for yourself that God can and he will.
Amen.
And you keep talking to God.
Amen.
And you keep talking to God.
Amen.
And after a while, all those fears, all those troubles is gone away.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But I come to tell you, you got to have some stumbling blocks.
Amen.
Because you got to overcome.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes my greatest fear will come upon me and I'll say, Lord, please, God, I know you got it. I know you got it. Because I don't care who you are, how big you are in the Lord, you have fears of certain things.
Amen.
I don't care who you
Amen.
Are.
Amen.
You got fears of something. But God can and he will deliver you. I thank the Lord for manifesting. One thing about it, she get up with a whole heart. She put a whole heart in it. And she don't mind presenting her own self first.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. So that's what we got to do. Amen. That's why the songwriter said, you can't tell it. Let me tell it. Amen. So God is good. And we thank the Lord today because he's everything. Amen.
Okay. I got a word today. Praise
amen,
God.
Amen.
Thank God for the speaker. It's been over 2 years since I heard her speak. With power, and I thank God for her.
Amen.
And let me tell you all something. God is good. I was getting dressed. And you know I started early because it take me 20 days to get my clothes on and get dressed. You know, that's how you can tell, Sister Richard. And it ain't about age because some of the young people don't dress no fast. But I'm just telling you.
Amen.
Let me tell y'all something. I'm getting ready to come, getting ready to probably get out the house. And the Lord say, tell them I do miracles.
Amen.
Now, if he do miracles, that includes me.
Amen.
But I'm hearing this again. Tell them I do miracles.
Thank you, God.
Yes.
And he said, in the scripture, people are so elated over wanting to be the minister, and they want to prophesy, whatever, whatever. It's a little small word in there. To another, I give miracles.
Yes.
Amen.
And when we see people, there are people at time points, God will just speak to them, and whatever's going on with you, it just evaporates.
Uh-huh.
It just evaporates.
Yes.
And so I said, right, God, that's a gift. And because everybody don't have it or don't ever get it, they don't want to talk about it.
Uh-huh.
But he let me know to another one, I give the gift of health,
so
but it's so tiny.
Yes. Right.
People look over the word help, but that ain't important. Mm-hmm. I tell you, son, that you can't change no child like me and somebody come along.
Amen.
I appreciate they help.
Amen.
And so I give another one, miracles. And I said, okay, I'm driving along. Tell them I give miracles. Okay. The scripture kept coming to me. And I guess I need to stick with that because that helps me. He said, good health.
Uh-huh.
And prosperity.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I say, you know what? This scrapping crumbs, it stops here.
Amen.
It stops here.
Amen.
There's something wrong with the people that's trying to serve God the best they know how. And they scrapping.
Yeah.
There's something wrong with the picture.
Amen.
So I'm saying, now, God, I'm a giver.
Uh-huh.
I don't never have nothing that I don't give to somebody.
Yeah.
Every month I sit down with my check and I try to figure out somebody that I can give something to.
Amen.
Either I give them something, some food, or I just walk up and put some money in their hand. That's it.
Yeah.
So I'm a giver. So what is holding me up? Well, Noelle, you need to go back and pray a little bit harder. And you know what we said, we done prayed all we can pray.
Uh-huh.
Then maybe I need to take another step. So then you come back. Good health and wealth. It is God's wish for you to have good health and wealth.
Uh-huh.
So I said, okay, I got to keep repeating that.
Yes.
Because I already said what I need to do between now and December.
Uh-huh.
But this miracle stuff kept coming. So when the Lord pressed me to go to church this morning,
Mama!
Just before I got ready to tell them what I'm telling you all, the man got up and he said, I need $7,000 or else they're not going to operate on me.
Mm.
And if they don't operate on me, he said, they give me 5 months. So he said, I don't know, I'm just going to pray. So I said, thank you, God. That's why you say you give me miracles.
Uh-huh.
Because I know a lady went on the internet with her problem, and so many people called her, she had an override of what she needed.
Uh-huh.
People say they're scared of the internet, but if you can read it and know everything else, you need to know when you might need to go on there.
That's
but
right.
You need to keep your conversation stabilized.
Uh-huh.
You need to stick to what you're on there for.
Yes.
Don't let nobody carry you over there to something that is not their business.
Amen.
So I said, God, I just take it for him. So I tell you all today, I'm motivated.
Yes.
I am motivated. Mm-hmm. And I say, I'm not scrapping anymore.
Amen.
I get to get what I want.
Uh-huh.
And so I told them, I know I tell. So they said, and yeah, and you know a lot of people like that because they're running the family. I said, they ain't running in mine. I'm not on that side over there. I don't care how many people in my family got it, that's them.
Uh-huh.
But I'm getting exempted. I told my family, I'm getting exempted from some of this stuff.
Amen.
Whatever I'm feeling, y'all, it's not my problem. Uh-huh. I pray for you. But so the lady said, well, I know you don't want to come in here because look what I got. I said, what did you got?
Uh-huh.
She said, well, you know, it might not be a good. Well, I tell you what, I'm going to pray for you.
Uh-huh.
And send her a chicken leg, but I'm not going to go over there. And it's something that I cannot help. I don't need nothing that I don't already have. Can y'all understand what I'm saying? You need to be truthful about me.
Yeah.
So I said, on the phone, I'm going to pray for you,
uh-huh.
But I'm not going over there right now,
uh-huh.
Because you have to be led to walk into people with all this stuff going on with you.
Yeah.
Because when healing is in you and you get around people real sick, when you leave them, you done got a headache you didn't start with, you done start slamming and talking smart, and all this stuff being drafted from them over there to you. Who needs it? So I said, I'm going to pray for you on the phone.
Yeah.
And we'll talk again next week.
Uh-huh.
And then I'll come over there. By that time, it's going to go down. But you know, do that apple cylinder.
And I'm going to
get it.
Yeah,
I'm getting there. And so, that's what, after she been up to that, then you see, the safe is only be there for me to go into a house. Now, I've got to look out for me.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody in my house had me a drink of water.
Uh-huh.
You know, I don't need nothing that I don't already have.
Uh-huh.
But I'm willing to pray for anybody by phone. They know that. I'm just being honest about it. Because you can tell people the truth.
Yeah.
You know, so he's doing miracles.
Yeah.
Nothing but a miracle has got him sitting here this long.
Yeah.
and still walking. Nothing but
Amen.
Miracles.
Yes.
So I'm here to tell y'all, it's in the Bible.
Uh-huh.
And the man said, well, if people holler about this and they can do that, I don't see none of that. You ain't going to see nothing because you ain't got nothing in them.
Uh-huh.
So I don't see why people, they see something. They see something. And the Lord told them this. And so I don't believe all that. And then he got ready to preach. He said, I started to preach here.
Watch this.
Same thing as they don't say. I started to preach on this, but something told me that to go here. That something. This is a chair. That's a rug. That's a table. But now you hear a voice and it's something. You don't even want to say, God, something told me. But you don't understand why other people get messages and they hear something.
Yeah.
You had to hear something to know that you need to leave that sermon alone and you need to go with this. But not God. Something told me that I need to change my... That was Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
See, so I thank God for you all today. Because I tell you the truth. I'm just telling everybody all this week because it starts with me. I'm looking for the miracle.
Yes.
And it is possible.
Yes.
See, and I thank God for her because a lot of people her age, they get a business or something that's going to their head and they could care less about God.
Uh-huh.
So when I see somebody is staying in business like she is, that's an encouragement to other young people.
Amen.
Yes,
she didn't get this business with food stamps. She had to work for it.
Yeah.
Yes. Not with food stamps.
Uh-uh.
I told her last night, this man just set this church up with food stamps so y'all can't keep on coming here like you don't have nothing. I strongly suggest you get food stamps, go buy some chicken legs and get this man some steak and something to help him with your tie. You know.
Yes.
If they ain't worth nothing, my income is low. Welcome to the union. My income is low. That's what we're going to discuss. Low income.
Yeah, I know that's right.
If you get paid bi-weekly, you better try to live within still bi-weekly. Y'all know what I'm saying? I say, yeah, mine low.
Uh-huh.
But I give.
Uh-huh.
And so you need to think about giving in order for you to get what your transportation,
that's
the way
right.
You need to go.
Uh-huh.
So I'm telling you all, I'm motivated today.
Yes.
And I'm believing that between now and the end of the year, everything that I have asked God for,
yes.
He's going to give it to me. Now, let me tell you something else, Reigns.
Amen.
To verify this, you know I'm going to learn how to sit down and help with God.
Go, come on.
This lady, to help you all know that it's true, she got up the other night and she said she had prayed because her bills was more than her income.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, God.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, now, Lord, I pray, I pay my tithe, I can't get my bills worked out. And she said, I need some extra money from somewhere. And she said, I went outside and I prayed and rubbed the mailbox and I said, send it by mail, send it by people, send it by air, but I need some money up in here. And she said, she was just saying, God, the time is right here. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen.
Let me tell you what happened. She said, I kept rubbing the mailbox. I kept opening the door looking for an unexpected person to come to my house. But the Bible said, he that believeth should have that blessing.
Oh, yeah.
She said she just prayed and prayed. And she said, Lord, ain't nothing in the mail. Now I'm serious. She said she was walking on that store and said, Lord, have mercy. The time done run out. And I got to have that money. And I don't want to have to go to them people. So she said she went on across the parking lot at the grocery store. Y'all, excuse me, this is my hamburger help I have to have with me every once in a while. So, you know, ain't the worst gonna happen. Let me tell you what. She said she was walking, there was a white envelope, mother. God. That was a white envelope. And she said she looked at it, it looked so clean. So she said she went down there. Now, sometimes you don't want to pick up. You know, sometimes you pick up stuff you don't need to pick up. I'm scared of germs. She said she went down there and picked the envelope up, sister. Eventually, she said it was heavy, it was kind of fat. Open up the envelope and she said, it's money in here. You know, it's funny thing, when you pick up money or something, you're going to look around.
Yeah, I know that.
She just went on back and sit down. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost over here. And so she opened up the letter. And I want you to know when she opened it up, Sister Francis, she said she kept counting. And the most she counted, money was just coming out, and she said it was $402. She said, I went back home, and she said, I just went around and thank God. She said, but everybody that I owed, it was enough. She said, and I went to the church and said, yeah, y'all can have this. Because God done bless me, I'm going to bless you people. But people get amnesia when they come to go to God. Y'all know that. It don't last long, but enough for them to spend all the money, then they get their mind back. So here we go. She turned around and she said she wouldn't get into the church. But when she got through paying all her bills, she said, even giving some money to the church, she only just needed a little bit. Sometimes $200 will carry you.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's just $100 and some. But hey, if you don't have it, and you looking at me and I ain't got the 20 pennies in the bank, I can't help you know what you gonna do.
Yeah.
You gotta go to Jesus.
Yes.
So God bless y'all, listen. And I'm glad to be in here. But I'm telling people, I believe in miracles.
Yeah.
Amen.
And I am not giving up on my miracles.
Amen.
Amen.
That's it.
Yeah.
If they never have nobody else, that's their problem.
Yeah.
If God done did it for 50,000 people, I'm just asking him to do it for me.
Yeah.
What you don't have, don't nobody know you don't have it, but God know you don't have it.
Amen.
What you heard about, everybody else don't know it, but God know it.
Amen.
So it's about time we stop talking to people who can't get to Main Street. Mm-hmm. We need to stop talking to people who got the same problem. I told the other day that you went over there telling her about, yeah, I went over there and told her, that's my friend, and I went over there and told her. Mm-hmm. I said, she done lost hers, too. That just don't make no sense. Why would you go to somebody got the same cotton picket problem you got?
Yeah.
You need to find somebody who done got past this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I mean, you can't talk to a loser. It just defeats the whole purpose.
Yes.
What you need, I don't need the same thing. I need to be done got past this, so when you tell me you need it, I can say, yeah, you know, I got out of that. Mm-hmm. And now I got 20 cents.
Yeah.
Maybe I can give you 10.
Yeah.
But if you don't have a 12 cents and I don't have a 10 cents, it's just going back and forth. Stuff you're talking. We both need to get somebody that they help. Y'all know, right?
Somebody ain't going to help you.
It don't work.
Honor to God, because honestly, I did not want to come today, but I came because of this little pain in me behind us running around. This morning, I had my landlord, they hired me and Mr. Tommy to go fix on some stuff at the other property, change the lock. And so we went this morning, and I dropped Mr. Tommy off and came back so he can take my TV down. When I got back home with him in the car, I said, oh, I'm so sleep. Sleep just came over me so hard. I said, oh, I'm so sleep. I'm going to just go back in the room and go to sleep. I don't want to go to church. He's talking about, we going to church. Yay! Oh, man, he want to go to church. I was like, no, I said, we're not going to church. He's talking about, yeah, church. Yay! Yeah, church. So I'm like, no church. He's talking about, yay, we go to church. I said, okay. Whatever. So I got up, went to get to the door, and I said, let me go on here. So I got ready. I said, I'm going to get ready myself and go to church. I lay across the bed real quick, started going through my phone, get asleep again. And so Levi came in there, and I was like, did you get ready for church? And he was like, no, you get ready. So I said, I don't feel like going to church. And he was like, why? I said, I'm going to go on. He's like, why? I said, because Isaiah want to go to church. So he's going to bring Isaiah in, trying to ask him a question to see if he really want to go to church. If he don't want to go to church, he want to play on his game. But I was like, you know what? Something just said, get up and come to church. And I thank God that I did, because all this money has been so hectic. But I tried to keep it to myself. And I had some unexpected bills. I need to consolidate my student loans. And the place where I'm renting is going to foreclosure. But I still have to pay my rent. But for some reason, when I went to go pay my rent, it said balance due zero. And I kept wondering, why wasn't there no emails saying your rent late. So I'm like, okay, something wrong. I'm not going to pay these people this money right now. I'm just going to hold on to it because I need it. When they call me, I give it to them because I got paid again. So I just tell God, thank you. I don't know if it's accounting oversight or what, but I promise you I need like 5 emails before it's time for my rent to be due. and I ain't get, I'm not, and I'm telling you, I even screenshot it. It says zero for the month of October. I said, something ain't right. So I said, I'm not saying nothing. And when they say they want to, and honestly, this particular time, they wanted to credit my account on my rent for the job that me and Mr. Tommy did. So I said, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to tell them I let Mr. Tommy go do it all by himself. Don't credit my account. I don't need to go, them to go in there and look at nothing and suspect and see that the rent wasn't paid yet.
Right.
So I said, you know what? I just tell God, thank you for the miracles and the blessings that's coming apart right now. Because I didn't want to give these people the